Hello, I'm Rashmi Bhandary, and today I have got two of my students who have cleared SAP. This year we had five students clearing SAP, so today I've got Aditya and Melvin, both from the CS branch. So both of you, please tell me how was SAP for you all, and how did you crack? And this year the numbers were very high, so I mean, any extra preparation, or I mean, what was the whole process about?
So the first process was the aptitude test.
Huh.
So initially, like there was questions from data structures, algorithms, and all those popular domains. And then
popular domains
even database, because SAP works mostly on database applications. So there'll be questions from database and data structures, and then there'll be two programming questions.
This usually is for the aptitude, but
aptitude. So usually programming actually contains more marks in most of the technical company. And the programming questions were relatively easy comparatively, because I had got we had got one of the questions was to sort the given years, like there was a program to sort the given years, and then there is one more to print the particular pattern. So you should be good at such programs, because printing a given pattern is almost most frequently asked questions in a aptitude test.
Okay.
And then, that's it.
And anything to add, Aditya, for this? During the aptitude, but there was no those logical, numerical and all that?
Numerical, no.
Nothing?
There were only technical.
Only technical.
Only technical. So, and the program, we could write it in any language. There was no any constraints.
Okay.
And the platform used was HackerRank.
Okay.
Yeah. And the eligibility criteria was 7 CGPA.
Okay.
And it was open for CS, IS and EC.
EC, okay. But they didn't look into your 10th and 12th marks?
No.
No, yeah. Only the engineering 7 CGPA. And I think all of you who have cleared have got almost like 8 and above. The final selects were all 8 and above.
8.
Yeah, and I think more close to at least from 200 students would have written, right? So, the first round, yes, as many as that. But then I think it was filtered. So, anything else? APTI, I mean, would you want to get into the specifics of your programmings, or that's about it?
That's about
online assessment,
that's it. So, it was easy for you all, because I think you're both very technically sound, so maybe it's easy.
It was easy.
It was easy. But for your friends, it's most of them, it was not easy, right?
It depends. Like the programming was, most of them told it was easy, but then the domain knowledge, like whatever we have studied from second year, right?
Okay.
So they have asked all of them. So it's like from the subject itself, it's not like difficult questions. It's like from the questions, but then it covers topics from second year. Like
second year on.
Yeah.
These are things that you have learned in your class, or this is something that you have actually, gone in depth?
We've learned all this in our class.
So everything that you study in your syllabus is there.
Yes.
And then you had the interviews. So, Aditya, how was your interview?
It went quite well, actually. There were 3 rounds of interview, out of which first 2 were technical, and the final one was HR. So, in the first round of technical, my interviewer asked me to introduce myself. Then he asked me for my favorite subject. So, I told him object-oriented concepts. After that, he asked me to explain in detail about object-oriented concepts, like 4 pillars of object-oriented concepts and classes and objects, all of
that. So this is a subject which you study in which year?
This is which semester?
Second year. Okay. But you were very comfortable with that, and you didn't forget.
No.
Okay. Usual answer is I forgot.
Because object-oriented concept is very important.
All right.
So after that, he switched to DBMS, since SAP works mainly on DBMS. So he asked me to draw an ER diagram. He had given me a table, and based on that, I had to draw the ER diagram.
Okay.
Then after that, he asked me questions on normalization and different types of it.
Okay.
Okay, that was about it. Then
any example, like you can say, okay, this is like, so that people understand, how is the sample question going to be like?
Okay. So, he had given me a student table with different details like USN, name, all that. And I basically, there is something called ER diagram in DBMS. I had to draw it.
Okay.
Right over there. And schema diagram.
Okay.
So that was it. Then normalization, that's what, there are different levels of normalization. I had to explain that too in detail.
All right.
Then from my from my resume, he asked me about my projects.
All right.
And finally, he gave me a
about program. Your project. So what project had you done?
I've done projects on Arduino based projects and app development.
Okay.
And that's
so how many projects had you mentioned?
My resume, I had mentioned 5.
All right. Oh, you had mentioned 5 resume projects. Five. Okay. Only 5. You did more.
I've done more, but I mentioned 5.
But how many projects have you done?
10?
I mean, 10 plus. Projects, yeah. All right. How did you manage to do? I mean, both of you? You have that many projects?
Yeah, ma'am, because most of the time we work in a team actually. So we participate in hackathons and all.
All right.
So that helps.
Okay, that would have helped you, right?
So yeah, hackathons.
Oh,
yeah.
Good, you told. So you had how many hackathons? I mean,
we participated in 4 and 4 yeah. 5. 4 to yeah. 5.
4 to 5. Yes, all right. So do all this happened in the college or did you go out?
In college, ma'am. Because in college, in second year, there was one by Jago Studios, I guess.
Yeah,
that was the first hackathon we participated. Yeah. And after that, there were some hackathons by, Dreamers and then department, our CS department.
CS department.
Yeah.
So those helped.
It helped a lot.
So did you?
Yeah, so in a hackathon, you can learn a lot overnight. So it helps a lot.
So you mentioned that in your resume?
Yes, ma'am.
We had mentioned the projects. Uh-huh. So they basically ask you about the project, right? Mm-hmm. So that time we mentioned we developed it in the hackathon. Mm-hmm. So the thing is
what do you develop in a hackathon? An app
so
or?
So hackathon, it's basically they will give a theme, uh-huh. particular like education or health sector like that. Uh-huh. So we have to basically make an app, website, anything.
Okay.
So we basically go with an app actually.
All right.
So hackathon, basically we cannot complete the entire project.
Huh.
So hackathon, we come up with an idea and just have a how it works, basically the flow.
Yes.
So later we complete it. So once you're done, we can put it in our resume. Because in resume, they expect us to finish the project.
Yes,
it's
yes.
not because like we just, because we have to explain how it works.
Yes.
So in hackathon, if you participate, we can get the idea and all the stuff, it will be ready.
Huh.
So later, we'll be in a team also. So later it will be helpful to complete the project.
All right.
Yeah.
So for you, how was your interview?
So the first round almost the same because even for me it started with the introduction and then again she asked me which is my favorite subject. So most of us we went with object oriented programming itself because the concepts are easier to explain. Object oriented programming because they ask us to explain each of the 4 pillars with an example for each.
Okay.
And with a real world example.
So give me a real world example.
For example, they ask inheritance.
Mm.
So inheritance, you can tell if you take a vehicle.
Mm.
So if you take vehicle as the main class, for example, car, bike, they all inherit from the vehicle. So such kind of an example.
Mm-hmm.
Like the simple example, it need not to be complicated.
Yes.
Simple example, so they can understand.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, for me, there was no database questions in first round.
Mm-hmm.
It was all in the second round.
Mm-hmm.
Then first round, she asked whether I have any questions.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked her for the introduction and you're done with the first round.
Mm-hmm.
Then in the second round, he went in depth. Whatever I have mentioned in resume, each tech stack, whatever technologies I have worked on, each one he started asking questions in depth.
Right.
And then projects again.
Huh.
Projects he asked me, explain each of the projects.
Uh-huh.
Okay, then after that, there was a question from database.
Uh-huh.
SAP, you can always expect database questions.
All right.
Okay, either in first round, most of them had in first round. I had it in second round.
Okay.
So basically, he had given me a table,
huh.
a structure he had given, how the data is stored. He told me I have to write a query to access the data from it.
Okay.
A simple one.
All right.
Okay, in particular range, I had to write a query to access the data.
Mm-hmm.
That was simple.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, there were questions from networking.
Mm-hmm.
So networking, it's how to share the files over FTP and how to connect different PCs over network.
Mm-hmm.
Simple questions, not complicated. These questions and all, we have it in our syllabus itself.
Yeah, but your answer in your syllabus is different, and that's why when you give that answer, So where is the thing that, everywhere where I've interviewed people, they said it was simple and is it? But then people don't clear. So what is it? I mean, can you give me an example of the sort of question for which you are given the answer? Because even though it's simple, but they're not looking at that, they know, they want to understand whether you've understood or not, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so can you give me any example, this is the question, so simple, but this is the answer.
Object oriented?
No, ma'am, the thing is, some people, like, as in, for example, I told how to transfer files over FTP.
Okay.
It's very simple, actually.
Yeah.
There's a protocol. You just have to, you have to tell how it is connected.
Uh-huh.
It's connected over IP, and it's, how it is transferred, like, all that stuff.
Yes.
But the thing is, most of us, when we study for the exam, we just mug up the entire process, like, how
yes.
it works.
Uh-huh.
But they don't want,
yes.
they don't want it in technical. Uh-huh. Like all the figures and
yes.
stuff. They just want to know how it works.
Yes.
Because that can be done in many steps. Because when I told my answer, when I told you can connect over the network and you can do it,
uh-huh.
he told it is one of the approach.
Uh-huh.
It's not like they don't want exact what is given in
mm-hmm.
textbooks. They're like, they'll see at your approach mainly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there are many ways you can do it. So
mm-hmm.
it is one of the ways.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like if you understood the concept,
mm-hmm.
so then you can answer it like any way you want, because it's not like one particular.
There's no
way.
Any particular.
Yeah, particular
way.
Fix this
okay.
one. Yeah.
All right. And you are both part of SOSE, right? The
yes.
Sayadri
open
source
community.
So you're both wearing the same T-shirts.
Yes.
yes? Yeah. So did it help? What do you do? And did that help being a part of
yes.
SOSE?
Talking about SOSE in all the three rounds helped a lot.
Yeah. So you spoke about
yes,
SOSE.
SOSE.
I can again see the spark. You know SOSE. So
yes.
yeah. No.
So, yeah, they were curious to know
huh.
more about SOSE.
Huh.
We told them what it is
uh-huh.
and what we do.
Okay.
So,
SOSE, what do you do?
Yeah. SOSE, as SOSE, we mainly promote open source.
Mm-hmm.
What open source is, it's in simple words, I can say that making a piece of code
mm-hmm.
available for free
okay.
and for public use.
All right.
So, that's basically open source.
Okay.
So, we mainly promote that.
All
and
right.
apart from that, we conduct many free workshops.
Uh-huh.
And events.
All
recently,
right.
we had conducted a hackathon. So there were around
the last hackathon.
Yeah,
I saw a lot of students. Yes,
yes.
Okay, that was done by you all.
Yes.
How
yes,
many
ma'am.
Participated?
Two.
There
40.
Were.
I mean, one.
Yeah. 150. Actually.
150.
Around.
This was
yeah.
for within the college or where outsiders
yeah,
also.
Like we had kept it for all the
yeah.
colleges. Actually,
okay.
the thing was the participation from our college was less.
Okay.
That is one of the.
Okay.
Because,
all right. And outsiders.
We try to promote in our college first because
okay.
we go to each classes
yes.
and call people.
All right.
Because we give preference to our college students
yes.
because we know how important hackathons are.
Yeah.
Because as we told, that's where we come up with an idea
yes.
and build all the stuff.
Uh-huh.
So that's why we conduct hackathons at
all
the
right.
first place.
But the
so
participation more for us was from outside.
Yeah, yeah.
I think they're so used to ghar ki murgi, you know, that's all. Huh? All right. But then you had that recent event, all right. So you, any other thing that you do in SOSE?
And we make projects, ma'am, like open source projects.
All right.
Like all our projects are open source on there's a platform called GitHub.
Okay.
All our projects are on GitHub.
I've heard this GitHub word
GitHub
before
yes,
also. What is this?
It's actually a platform where basically you can put your project over there.
So any student who's actually an engineer should be putting his their projects
yes,
on GitHub?
Yes.
Yeah.
The companies
help.
Actually look for this.
So they could actually put it up.
Yes.
So
because
it could be a first year, second year, third
yes,
year.
Like once you join the company, right?
They
most of them use GitHub.
Okay.
Because the thing is, it's like if multiple people are working on one particular
mm-hmm.
project,
mm-hmm.
they have to, like the code will be there, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like they'll be working on one project.
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be like code written for that.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, in GitHub, you can easily manage all that code.
Mm-hmm.
Like if I am working on one part, if he's working on other part,
mm-hmm.
so it has you have to put together the entire thing.
Okay.
So previously it was considered if he's working on different, he has to give me the pen drive and
yes.
I have to copy entire thing. So now it is like in GitHub,
mm-hmm.
it's just I'll put the code online, even he will put, it will combine and it's like
Everyone is
has access
to okay.
the same
okay.
code.
Like the
yeah.
open source community, everyone has access same way in GitHub.
Yeah,
like open
even
source.
That
okay.
one we can control, like who can have access. But then, yeah, it's better if they know GitHub. If they start using from second year itself, if they get familiar.
Okay.
So it's one of the advantages. Like in company, like during interviews, if you tell I'm good with GitHub and all, it helps a lot.
All right.
Yeah.
Huh? So I thank you very much. And I just hope this was helpful to you all. So I think that's about it. Until we meet again, it's bye.